Our senses convert the sights and sounds of the world we experience into electricity, or more precisely, complex patterns of neural activity. Each cone in your eye, and you've got millions of them, is directly connected to the back of your brain. Every time a single cone is activated, a corresponding signal can be seen in the brain. It's a straight path, but not a single neuron. Several neurons are used, each passing off the signal to the next. So let's start with a single neuron and work our way up. A neuron is a single cell. Like all cells, it has a nucleus and other organelles that maintain cell life. A neuron also has at least one extension, what looks like an arm or tail. A unipolar neuron is just the soma and a long tail. This extension is called an axon. It carries a signal away from the soma. This design works well for sensory neurons. A temperature or pressure receiver activates the soma of a unipolar neuron, and it sends the impulse down the axon to the spinal cord and brain. A version of a unipolar neuron that has a T-intersection is often used to signal the spinal cord and a muscle at the same time. These pseudopolar neurons have the soma off to the side, and its extension essentially acts like two axons, taking information in two different directions. Bipolar neurons can be found in the retina and nose. To me, a bipolar neuron is like a ball with two arms. One arm receives incoming signals, and the other arm transmits that signal to other neurons. Here's how it works. A cone in the retina fires and activates a portion of the dendrite. The signal goes to the soma, which collects the inputs. When there is enough stimulation to trigger an impulse, the soma fires an electric charge down the axon. The fourth type of neuron is the most common. It's the multipolar neuron. To me, it's like a ball with a hat and a long tail. There are multiple branches of dendrites and a long arm with several branches. All the neurons work the same way. Part of the cell, usually a dendrite, but sometimes the soma or the axon, is stimulated. This activation causes chemical changes inside the cell, which causes it to impact other neurons. There are two ways for neurons to interact. Sometimes the activation is electrical. Think of it as two wires getting crossed. Obviously, the two neurons have to be virtually touching each other for this to occur. Sometimes this cross-neuron activity is good. Some parts of learning and memory use electrical activation. It also be bad, causing spasms and epileptic tremors. The second method of neural activation is chemical. A chemical is secreted by a gland or other neuron. It floats into the intercellular space and runs into the dendrite of our neuron. The chemical, called a neurotransmitter, binds to one of the receptors covering the dendrite, which causes our neuron to fire. A neuron is essentially a rechargeable bionic battery. It starts with a full charge, gets activated, needs some time to recharge, and then can fire again. When activated with electricity or chemical, a neuron creates a flow of electrically charged ions. They race down the axon and release chemicals that in turn activate other neurons, all inside a single cell.